If you are going to start solving word problems, there is actually one small item that you should be aware of and be careful of as well when you're going to start to try to solve these word problems. And that is having consistency in trying to solve for the correct quantity and also trying to use the correct units. Now, you might be using the correct quantities, but the units might not line up. And this is where the consistency problem arises. Now, I have done an introduction to kind of solving word problems. I'll put up a link up above there. You probably should watch that first before you watch this. Now, in terms of consistency, so what I mean, if you're looking at this particular table where you have these quantities from distance, mass, time, temperature, and so on, we have our symbols. Now we have all of these different units, and notice the one key thing is that when you're solving for a quantity, you may not have every single measurement in that particular word problem having the exact same units that you want to be able to use. And what I mean by that is, so for instance, if you're solving for distance, you might be reading the word problem and maybe some of the measurements are in centimeters. And then maybe another measurement is maybe in meters. And you have to be careful because you want to make sure that those two are consistent. Let me just show you, okay, so kind of through examples, what this consistency is all about, and then what you should be aware of. So you don't blindly start adding, okay, or maybe multiplying or dividing something, and it may lead to the answer which you may not really want to have. Now, hopefully, it will become intuitive as I give you some of these examples. So, for instance, I've prepared a set of examples here. And for all of these examples, or at least for most of them, they're kind of inconsistent. So, whatever word problem you might be solving, okay, so I'm not giving you a word problem within here, but let's say you pick up the information and then you want to try to start adding or subtracting or maybe multiplying or dividing. And you want to see, if there is consistency. So, for instance, here for our first example, right here. Now, people are very aware, that one is $25, and then the other one, you maybe not be as familiar with that symbol. Okay, so it's kind of 10 euros. I guess they typically put little two lines through that as well. Now, if you want to be able to add that, you can't just blindly say, this is 35, because it's 35 what? When one is in dollars, so maybe that's in US dollars, okay, and then this one is in euros. So this, okay, is inconsistent. It's inconsistent in the units, and you would have to either, so depending on what you are working on, so let's say you either convert everything into euros or you want to be able to convert everything into dollars so that it is consistent so that you can add it. And that's what we mean by consistency. Now, this really pops out at you, and most students that are probably watching this, be like, yeah, okay, this doesn't make any sense. But it's also subtle in other ways, okay, depending on what quantities you might be solving for. So clearly, this is not the case, and we would have to convert this back, okay, if it was needed. So you have to watch out for that when you're reading your word problems. Okay, so the second example that we have, which is this one, so notice that this is a subtraction, and again, if you ignored your units, you might think that this is, 180, okay, as a result, but of course, you need some units in here. Now, what units do you give? Well, this is milligrams and this is grams. So we know that we're trying to solve for some mass. And again, you can kind of go back into the table here and then check what you are trying to solve for. So if we're trying to solve for mass, we do need, although our quantities align, okay, it is both are measurements of mass, but milligrams is a much smaller unit than a gram. And you definitely can't just say 190 minus 10. So initially, when you're solving these, if you're writing out your givens or if you're trying to set it up, it is maybe wise to try to keep the units there just as a reminder, am I being consistent or not? Because this clearly cannot be 180. You're going to again have to create and convert to some unit which is consistent. So you either change to milligrams or you're going to change everything to grams. All right? That is consistency. That's what you need. Now, in the third example, so this one has, you know, 68, it says BPM. Now, what is BPM? You can look up in the table if you want, okay? So in this particular table, BPM is actually beats per minute in this case. So we're solving for some kind of frequency in here. And now, so notice we have 68 beats per minute here. We want to add it to 86 beats per minute, and we want to add it to 100 beats per minute. This is consistent. In the denominator, we can go ahead and add these up because everything is in beats per minute. And then we're just dividing by three. So maybe this is some kind of an average, maybe for your heart rate. Okay, maybe they took three readings. Okay, maybe the word problem was with regards to some heart rate average, and you know, you had three readings and you want to take the average, so you divide it by three. Notice this three has no unit. So if there is no unit there, then you can go ahead and divide. All right, so that is consistent because we do have the same units there. Now, if I move over to the next one, so notice here, it looks like I am trying to add up two volumes together. Again, we do have a problem of inconsistency. One is in milliliters, one is in liters. So, you know, this is no good. So we have to be careful, and we're going to have to kind of convert this back. So in your word problems, watch out and make sure that, you know, when you have a quantity, that you're being consistent in the units throughout. Here are a couple of other examples. So here's, for example, a multiplication. So it says 5 milliliters per minute multiplied by 15 hours. So now within here, if you try to do this, I mean, sure, you can say 5 times 15, and we're going to, you know, to get an answer. So that's going to be, I guess, 75. But the problem here will be, so, you know, you can multiply the numbers, you'll get 75. But notice your unit, so you're going to have milliliters per, so this was minute, this is coming from right here. And then you multiply by hours. So this is going to be times hours in here. And nothing really cancels. And most likely, I'm just assuming, I don't know what the word problem was, but milliliters per minute, it seems like it's some kind of volume flow that you have. And then, you know, it looks like it's being administered for like 15 hours or something like that. So I don't know what exactly that might be. But what I do know is that my time, okay, so notice the time here is in hours and the time here is in minutes. So what you want to be able to do if you do this multiplication, there's actually nothing wrong in doing this, but you have to keep the units. But if someone was reading this and they said 75 milliliters per minute times hours, they'll be like, I don't know what that means. And most likely you want these minutes and hours to try to cancel. So what you would have to do is you would have to most likely change these 15 hours to maybe, you know, how many minutes there are. Now there are 60 minutes in an hour. So, you know, you can convert that all 15 hours times 60 minutes to get the total number of minutes. And then the minutes would cancel out for you. Okay. And that would have been consistent in the time unit for that cancellation. So again, that's something that you have to be aware of, okay, when you're staring at the units, so that things are being consistent. And the same problem we run into here in the last one, which is, looks like it's maybe, you know, your hourly rate, maybe you're making $35 an hour. And, you know, you certainly, when you multiply by 520 minutes, you might get the illusion. Now, I actually, you know, I'm not going to try to wing that from my head, but you know, if you multiply this, you might get pleasantly surprised and you'd be like, oh my gosh, I made $18,200. Well, no, you didn't, because your units were inconsistent. Here it says you were making $35 per every single hour. And then here, this is, you know, probably saying that you worked for 520 minutes. So, you know, convert this back to hours. And you can do that, you know, again, you know that there's 60 minutes in an hour. So if you're going to be converting, in this case, you would have divided by 60 minutes per hour, and that would have told you how many hours you worked. And then you can do your actual calculation. That is consistency. That is something you have to be aware of. And I do find that students, when they're reading word problems, sometimes they'll set them up correctly, but they forget about this consistency. And in some professions, this is actually a very big problem, because if things are inconsistent, you know, let's say if it was healthcare, then you might give a patient the wrong dosage because you had inconsistent units that you were worried about. And again, if it was something like business right here, you know, you might overpay somebody by quite a bit because you haven't been consistent in your calculation. So you do need some kind of check for yourself. And I always tell, you know, anybody who's doing word problems, be careful. Okay, that's consistency for you. Thanks for watching. See you in a future video. Ciao.